Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to today's video, which is a look at using teleconverters on the Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras. In particular, I'm using the FZ200 today, but it applies to the FZ150 and the FZ100 as well if you have those cameras. The procedure might also apply to other bridge cameras if you've got the right adapter tube to support the teleconverter lens. In this video, I want to look at using the teleconverter with the Panasonic Lumix FZ200 camera, the adapter tube that you have to use to enable you to support the lens on the camera, some of the mounting hardware that you might need to mount the teleconverter tube onto the camera and then affix that to the tripod, as stability is one of the issues you do have using these long teleconverter lenses. I'm also going to show you a method of using a close-up lens to reduce the working distance that the teleconverter and camera combination has. When you're in the extended teleconverter mode with these lenses, the closest focus distance can be as much as 5.5 meters. If you want to get closer than that, then with my tip of using a close-up lens between the teleconverter lens and the main lens, you'll be able to get down to about 1.5 meters or 2 meters in some instances. First of all, let's look at the hardware. This is not the original Panasonic LTE55 teleconverter lens. It's a VCL DH1758 converter from Sony. It's got a 58mm thread which fits the 58mm Aperture adapter that I bought rather than the LA7. So the correct combination if you're going to use the Panasonic lenses is the LA7 tube with the LTE55 lens. This particular extension tube is one I purchased on eBay and about a third the price of the Panasonic tube, and it splits into two. One is for the short coupling for attaching wide angle lenses, and the other gives you the full extension length for fitting the teleconverter. The actual teleconverter tube itself is supported on this tripod by use of the Canon Model D tripod mounting ring. The actual ring is slightly oversized, so you have to make up the diameter of the extension tube to give you a snug fit on the tripod ring by about 6 layers of electrical tape. Once you've done that, you get a real snug fit of the tube onto the tripod mounting ring. Then the whole thing is mounted on a rather sturdy tripod. One thing you will suffer from with this sort of setup is vibration. If there's any wind blowing, that will oscillate the camera. If you've got the camera set up on ground, which is going to be vibrated by passing traffic, you'll also notice some vibration. You'll also notice that sometimes with the mechanical shutter in the camera, it's enough to make the camera oscillate and you'll get a reduction in resolution of your pictures. One way of getting around that mechanical vibration is to use the electronic shutter in the burst mode. Unfortunately, that limits the resolution of the picture to 3.5 megapixels. So if you're using the picture for use in HD video or something like that, that probably is good enough resolution. But if you want to make prints, then unfortunately 3.5 megapixel is only enough for 6x4 print size. The official way that Panasonic have you set up this combination with the FZ200 is to use the teleconverter setting in the setup menu. When you engage the teleconverter setting, it limits the zoom to from 14 to times 24. So you only have that range of 14 to 24. That's so you don't get any vignetting from the inside tube, as I'm demonstrating now on this video. But you can use it without using the T setting, providing you use the manual zoom to get you beyond the times 14. With the preset condition, you are limited to F4 as well, so you can't use the F2.8 setting of the lens. So there's another tip for you. If you want to use the F2.8 setting of the lens if you're in a dark situation, then you can use the manual setting with the camera rather than using the T setting. I'll show you those setups on the back of the camera now so you can get a better idea. Here we can see in the record setup menu the conversion facility, which is on page 5. And if you cursor to the right, you can see that we have the option of using close-up lenses or the teleconverter setting. So if we select teleconverter and then come back out of the menu by hitting the shutter button, you can see that we're at times 14 and the screen is displaying the message that the current setting is teleconversion mode, so you can't go less than 14. And you notice that we can go up to times 24, and if you've got the digital zoom enabled, then you can go to times 96. What I'm suggesting is you don't use the conversion facility, you leave that set to off, and you can see that at times 14 we've still got a little bit of zoom to play with before we start to vignette. You can see that the tube is starting to vignette at that point, which is about times 5, and it gives you the benefit that you can still use the f2.8 aperture if you wanted to. In the teleconversion setting, you notice that we are limited to f4. If you're going to be shooting video with this combination, then the rule for video is that you use a shutter speed which is twice the frame rate, and that gives you the 180 degree shutter rule. So if you're shooting 50-60 frames in AVC HD or MP4, then you should be using a shutter speed of about 1/125th of a second. Now sometimes in bright light you can't achieve 1/125th at f11, which is the maximum aperture this supports in video mode, and that you have to use neutral density filter. Obviously you don't want to be trying to fit a neutral density filter which is the diameter of the extension tube. You can actually fit it to the native lens of the camera, so screw your ND4 or ND8 filter onto the camera lens and then reattach the extension tube, and then you can get your shutter angle the way that it should be for video. If you want to be taking close-up pictures as well, you'll find that the minimum focus distance you get with a teleconverter lens is about 5.5 meters. So if you want to be shooting things like butterflies at a fairly close distance with the teleconversion assembly, you'll need to use a close-up lens on the prime lens of the camera to reduce your working distance. And I'm going to do that now to try and take some pictures of these reeds behind me. So I'm going to try and get the camera as close as I can. I have here my set of close-up lenses, the 1, 2 and 4. I'm probably going to use the number 2 to give me a closest working distance for that scene behind me. So I'll install the number 2 lens on the camera lens and then reassemble the assembly. To give you an idea of the amount of identification with the system, the seed head is about a meter away, and if I show you the size of this lens cap, which is a standard 52mm lens cap, you can see the size of image that we've managed to get. So that is the procedure for setting up a teleconversion lens on the Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras using the necessary adapter tube. So that's the LA5 for the FZ150 and the LA7 for the FZ200 to match your teleconverter lens. Here are some images I shot today using this combination around the nature reserve, just to give you some idea of the image quality you can get using this combination with the bridge camera. F7.1, F6.3, F5.6, F4, F2.8. More hens about 10 meters away. So there we are. That's the procedure for setting up the teleconverter lens on your Panasonic new bridge cameras. Hope you found that useful. And of course, if you don't subscribe to our channel, please consider clicking the link above this video now, and then you'll be notified of when I do upload new videos to this channel. So thanks again for watching. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.